Welcome to The Gift of Life with Gregg. I'm your host, Gregg Francis, and I'm joined today by my co-hosts, Barry Kaplan and Leora Lieberman. We save lives, plain and simple. Have you known someone stricken with leukemia? Has a family member of yours suffered from lymphoma? Then turn up your dial. This show is for you. We are the gift providing a second life. We are the gift of life. Since 1999, we saved over 2,700 lives. For many patients with blood cancer, bone marrow donation is often their last hope, and that's where we come in. We try hard at what we do, but we will never be satisfied until we can say, one day, we found a match anytime, anywhere, for anyone. That's the gift of life way. So now we have the scissors, we've opened the box, and now it's time to unwrap the gift of life. Hello everyone, and welcome to our ninth show. I tell you, the first eight shows have been magnificent. However, today, we're going to go back to our roots and send out a challenge to our listening audience. As I mentioned, September is my favorite month, as it marks the beginning of football season. And I'm proud of my Jets for opening up with a win. Barry, it wasn't a pretty win, but nonetheless, it was a win.
They fought for it. So.
They fought for it. They made it more interesting than they had to. And for those who started your fantasy football season, and according to ESPN, about 32 million of you, please call in and let me know how you did this week. For those who have been our supporters this season, welcome back, both fantasy football and Gift of Life. And we thank you for all that you've done to spread awareness and transpire action for our show and for our cause. Because of you, we are ranked the number one radio show on 1470 WWNN, our flagship station, as well as being the number one bone marrow radio show worldwide. Now, Barry, as I mentioned last week, thanks to our listeners, we're going to be syndicated in six major cities, and we found out from our producer, Freddie, which they are. One is Atlanta, two is Philadelphia, three is right here in Boca Raton, four is in Boston, five is in Las Vegas, and six is in the Windy City, Chicago.
Wow, the list just goes on and on.
It is. So what's going to happen, it's going to raise more awareness, more people swabbing, more contributions, and in the end, it'll culminate with more lives being saved. And that's what we're all about, a gift of life. So for all the people who are tuning in for the first time, we're so glad you could join us for Gift of Life with Gregg. We broadcast live from Boca Raton every Tuesday from 4 to 5 p.m. here on our flagship station, WWNN 1470. So today's show is going to be about wish lists, also known as bucket lists, but I like wish lists better. So we have a challenge to present to our listening audience later on today, and we really want you to take advantage of it. For those who tuned in last week, you know that September is Blood Cancer Awareness Month, and please listen to what I'm about to say. Please spread awareness. Pacific Islanders are having a tough time getting people in the registry. Hispanic people are underrepresented. Asian people are underrepresented. African Americans are underrepresented. I'm asking our listeners to become involved, spread the word, be proactive, because we have the resources in this country to eradicate this disease. It's very quick to just get swabbed, join the worldwide registry, and, you know, help save people's lives. If you want to get involved, please call Bridget. She's waiting for your call at 1-800-9-MARROW. So BK, let's get the party started today. We have a great show for everyone. If you're joining us for the first time, I'm Gregg Francis. Welcome to our show. We encourage our listeners to call in at any time at 1-888-565-1470. The number, Barry?
That's 1-888-565-1470.
All right. So if you're inspired by what we do, if we motivate you to celebrate life, we want you to call in. We want to hear about it. So please call into the show today, along with my co-host, Barry Kaplan, who's fighting a cold, but he's going to tough it out this hour. and Leora L Squared Lieberman, who again is on special assignment. We're here to spread awareness about the Gift of Life Bone Marrow Foundation, a life-saving nonprofit that gives patients like our six-year-old friend Sammy a second chance at life. We want to remind everyone of how special life is and how every day of health and happiness is a true gift of life. So as is a mantra of this show, before I go further, I have to thank my own gifts of life, people who make me smile, laugh, you know, remind me of how lucky I am. To undoubtedly my biggest fan, my mom, Katie, who's in first place in our office contest. Mom, I think you're listening in Lake Worth today. Thank you so much. We made it through eight. I love you. To my biggest Maryland fan, hello and thank you, Grandma Margie. I hope that you enjoy the show, and she is a renegade spreading the word in Maryland, D.C., and Virginia. And to my two sons, who are my gifts of life, and some of you might have seen them this week at the Fantastic event, Nicholas and Patrick, who are 11 and 7 years old, respectively. Hello, Pat. I'm excited that we start soccer tomorrow. The Mighty Terrapins, our team, will have a great season. And Nick, I really want you to thank, I really want to thank you, Nick, for coaching with Daddy. I also want to say hello to a special guest and a friend of mine. Rafi's in from Israel. Rafi is a wealth of knowledge, but more importantly, a genuinely wonderful person. So, Raf, I hope that you're going to enjoy the show, and I believe you're listening for the first time. So without further ado, let's turn it over to my co-host, BK Barry Kaplan.
Good afternoon, everyone. Name's Barry Kaplan, fighting a cold here, but hopefully we'll get through. And want to start out first, you know, going to throw a curveball over here, but this month is Blood Cancer Awareness Month. And this past year, an extended family member of mine passed away from blood cancer. She was a second cousin of mine, but happened to be quite close to me personally. So I want to echo the sentiment that you just gave, Gregg, about blood cancer awareness. Awareness starts with you, people. It starts with our listeners. It starts with people getting the word out. Blood cancer is indiscriminate. Although the cure for blood cancer is rooted in different ethnic backgrounds and representation of those ethnic backgrounds in the registries, blood cancer doesn't care what the color of your skin is or what ethnicity you are or what have you. So that's why it's a team effort. And I beg and implore everyone out there to please join the registry. And if you'd like to join the registry, please go online at www.giftoflife.org or call us at 1-800-9-MARROW. Again, it's Blood Cancer Awareness Month. Let's tackle this thing head on and we can all do it together. So with that, I wanna go ahead and take a minute to do some housekeeping.
Very entertaining weekend. I want to send a special thank you to Jenna Hernandez. I think that she did a wonderful job putting this event together.
That's right, the Fantastic Family event. I want to thank everyone for coming out to the Fantastic Family Festival. It was this past weekend. We had over 250 people actually attending. So
they braved the weather.
Yeah, it was interesting because I live down the street from where the event went on, and I woke up to thunder, so I was a little nervous about that. But you know, of course, right when the event started at 4 o'clock. Everything cleared up, and it ended up being a really wonderful time. Special shout out to Bobby the Balloon Master.
What is he?
Yeah, Masters. Yeah. Yeah, man, he is funny. He is a funny guy and an amazing balloon artist.
He was absolutely fantastic. I would definitely recommend him for any event.
Yeah, Bobby the Balloon Masters. I can't describe what he made. I mean, hats, swords, different types of apparel. Girls got little butterfly wings out of balloons. It was incredible.
A fishing rod with a fish.
Yeah, fishing,
frogs.
Yeah, it was really interesting stuff. I believe your son actually got a Google Eyes, right?
I took a picture. It was really
frog
neat.
Frog eyes or something. Yeah. In the end of the show, he actually climbed out of a giant whoopee cushion. I couldn't believe it.
I don't know how he got in. I don't know how he got out. But that's something that he's a magician, right?
Yeah, he's
a balloon
savant. He called himself a balloon
savant. Yeah,
funny guy. He actually made a joke about the Federal Reserve. I couldn't, of all the things to make to joke about at a children's party. Moving on to some future events. We got a walk on Sunday, a walk for life. It's a 5K walk, and it's located, I know we have a lot of listeners around the globe, actually around the domestic United States, especially in New York, New Jersey, and Maryland, D.C. area. We have a walk for life coming up on Sunday for everyone located in the New York area, specifically on Long Island. It's located on East Meadow.
Being a native Long Islander,
please, Gregg.
Yeah, it's central to all the main thoroughfares. So Southern State, Northern State, LIE. If you're listening in New York, it's the most accessible place on the island to get there. So no excuses for you not showing up.
Our in-house Long Islander there telling you to come out to the event. It's on September 14th. It's this Sunday. It's a 5K walk. It's $35 at the door admission. Now, you can save some money. I'll tell you how on the registration. Go online, www.giftoflife.org, and you'll save about $5, and admission will only be $30 online. Isn't that right, Gregg?
Yeah, it's $30 if you register online. We're going to have raffles. We're going to have events. We're going to meet a donor recipient are going to meet for the first time. We've had a great committee putting this event together in New York. It's going to be a great day. We're expecting between 350 to 400 people.
Yeah, and if you are tuning in just now and are not familiar with what Gift of Life does, we're a national bone marrow registry, and what we do is we help people with blood cancer find matches and hopefully treat their cancer and hopefully cure them of their cancer and other ailments. And what we're going to have on September 14th, this coming Sunday, is a donor and recipient meeting for the first time ever. And for those of you who are not familiar with that experience, I mean, there's no other way to describe it than just a completely earth-shaking emotional moment. Basically, a complete stranger came out of nowhere and saves another complete stranger's life just out of sheer will.
And that's the beauty of what we do. It culminates in not only the patient being saved, but the family as well. Coupled with the fact that some other of our Long Island friends will be celebrating their 5 and 10 year transplantiversary.
Exactly, Gregg. You know, these transplants, when a transplant occurs, a lot of people who go through the transplant process see it as a second birthday. So a 5 year anniversary, a 10 year anniversary, these are really large milestones.
Yeah.
Really large milestones, and they should be celebrated, rightly so. So we really want to ask everyone who's in the area to come and celebrate with us. Have a great time.
It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be emotional. It's going to be uplifting. And most of all, it's going to be positive. 400 people going to be marching and contributing and showing support to get more matches, because all the proceeds of this event on Sunday are going to go to test more kits.
That's a point that I wanted to make, Gregg.
Sorry.
No, it's by all means. Every dollar that you spend at this event on the registration is going to go towards testing kits. And what does that mean? That means that you will directly have a direct benefit to saving someone's life. And your registration can very well pay for the kit that ends up saving someone's life. So I implore everyone in the area to go out. It's at Eisenhower Park in East Meadow, just like you said, Gregg, basically on any thoroughfare you can find yourself in that area. And registration starts at 10 a.m.
10 a.m. No, 10 a.m. is the walk. Let's get there. We'll get ready to roll between.
That's correct. My
no, bad. No. 9 o'clock. Let's register. 10 o'clock. We're ready to walk, and it's going to be 5K for those that want to run. Let's get it rolling, and we'll have a great time.
Yeah, and the next event that I want to talk about is our seasonal bowling tournament. It's going to be on October 19th. It's going to be in Boca Raton, Strikes of Boca. We had one actually this past summer. It was a wild success, in my opinion. Gregg, what did you think about it?
I thought it was great. It was roughly 40 bowlers, as we mentioned on previous shows. All four of the winners gave all or some of their prize money back to the Gift of Life, which wasn't expected. The final game actually was a tie, so we had to have a two-frame roll-off. We had a 300 game, we had a 290 game, and most of all, we had a lot of fun and got awareness out.
I mean, you could have tore it out of a magazine. It seems so pre-written. You know, we happen to have a tie at the end of the last two frames. I couldn't believe it. You could have cut the tension with a knife in that room. It was great. Anyways, this bowling tournament is the Strikes for Life bowling tournament. It's located at the Strikes at Boca Bowling Alley, which is on Military Trail, in between Glades and Palmetto, I believe.
And for this tournament, it looks like we're expecting 150 bowlers, which is about four times what we had at our inaugural one. And the first place prize is $1,500. So one out of every six bowlers is going to get paid. Most of all, we'll have more people that may not know about blood cancer and, again, spread awareness. But I do promise everybody will have a great time if it's half as fun as the first one.
You know, that's the point that I want to emphasize, Gregg. We had so much fun at that first bowling tournament that people didn't realize that all of it was going towards charity. You know, it completely passed their mind. Right at the end of the night, you kind of realized, wait, I had this great time, and every single penny went towards directly impacting people and saving their lives, possibly. This is great. I want to do more of it. And so that's why we're doing this next tournament.
Yeah, it was something that we were going to look at doing annually, but since we had such positive feedback and people enjoyed it, it's going to a great cause. It's something that we're going to try to do on a quarterly basis.
So we're going to be having that on October 19th. Registration is going to be at 9 a.m. for the Strikes for Life. The pins go down at 10 a.m., so balls will roll at 10 a.m. And again, just like you said, Gregg, we're going to have a $1,500 first prize. We'll have a bunch of different types of games you can play, 50-50s, high scratch pots, brackets, you name it. I can go on and on with those. The tournament is going to be a four-game sweep, with one out of six people are going to be able to cash out from this game. So there's an easy way to find the win, I'll tell you.
Yeah,
that.
No, you're going to bowl four games. The top four people are going to advance to a stepladder tournament, but one out of every six cash.
So it sounds like it's going to be a great time, and you'll be able to see Gregg and myself there on October 19th. Gregg, speaking of bowling, I heard you had a special accomplishment last night. Why don't you tell us about that?
And our team did quite well. We swept last night.
What team was that?
We have two Gift of Life bowling teams. One that we bowl in Boca, and we took 30 out of 35 points. And the one last night, we took, you know, 9 out of 9. We did okay.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't really bowl. I'm a layman. So don't be humble. Just tell me what it is.
All right. I know what you're getting at. We won all three games, and last night I bowled a 300.
300 out of what?
300. It's called a perfect game. So thank you, Barry.
Wow, and correct me if I'm wrong, you get some jewelry from that too, right?
Yes, you get a ring. It was a lot of fun, and I had a lot of fun with my teammates. I got, I think, a little lucky on the last ball, but nonetheless, I hope that I represent a Gift of Life well.
Yeah, congratulations. Perfect 300. You know, you can't sneeze at that. So, I mean, yeah, you can't get better than a 300 pins falling down.
So, so that's what we have on the horizon for events. We're going to take a quick commercial break, but what I want you to think about during the commercial is what is on your wish list or bucket list that you want to accomplish within the next 6 months. And we expect you to call in at 1-888-565-1470. And we'll be right back after a few messages.
Throwitbetter.com. Do you need help with your bowling game? Are you taking the right five-step approach? If you want to become a competitive bowler, even a recreational bowler that's considering joining a league, or a league bowler that's considering joining a tournament, you need to see Vince. He's going to show you how to throw it better. He'll get you the right equipment, he'll show you the right approach, and as a certified coach himself, he'll put you in the best position to succeed. If you're interested, please visit Vince at throwitbetter.com and tell him that Gregg sent you. Again, that's www.throwitbetter.com. If you own a business and have the need for commercial insurance, I suggest you call Chris Moore of Brown & Brown Insurance in Fort Lauderdale. Chris has been in the commercial insurance business for over 30 years and can handle any company's need for property, general liability, workers' compensation, and automobile, just to name a few. Brown & Brown, being countrywide and the fifth largest agency in the country, gives Chris the tools he needs to meet all your insurance needs. So call Chris at 954-331-1420. Again, that's 954-331-1420. 954-331-1420. 334-331-1420. We want to extend a special thanks to our friends at the Boca West Foundation for all the wonderful work they do for Gift of Life and for all the meaningful service they give to the Boca Raton community. For over 3 years, the Boca West Foundation has generously supported local charities in the Boca Raton area. The Boca West Foundation, it's all about the kids. Are you in the market for a health plan? If so, please visit my good friend Gary at Health Plans Unlimited. No plan is too big or too small. Gary will customize a plan that's affordable and comprehensive just for you. If you're interested, please visit Gary Goldman, the best in the biz, at www.healthplansunlimited.com. Again, that's www.healthplansunlimited.com. Or you can call Gary Goldman directly on his personal line at 954-303-6676. Again, that's 954-303-6676. And tell him that Gregg sent you directly from the Gift of Life. Health Plans Unlimited. We have the health plan for you. Welcome back to the Gift of Life with Gregg, the show that talks about giving and receiving. I'm your co-host, Leora Lieberman, and I'm here with my host, Gregg Francis, and co-host, Barry Kaplan. If you'd like to call into our show, we'd love to hear from you. Please call 888-565-1470. Again, that's 888-565-1470. And now, back to our show.
And we're back with the Gift of Life with Gregg. Barry Kaplan here. We're taking your calls all this hour. If you want to call in at 888-565-1470. Again, that's 888-565-1470. Gregg, you were just talking about earlier a challenge that you wanted to issue out. Why don't you tell the audience more about this challenge that you speak of?
Thanks, BK, and I'm proud of you for, you know, fighting this cold through. I know that you're not feeling great today.
That's fine.
But here's the challenge. I want to hear from our listening audience about what is on your quote-unquote wish list. What's preventing you from accomplishing it? How will you accomplish it within the next 6 months? And if you do so, I want you to email me at gfrancis@giftoflife.org. We're going to pick three people who accomplish an item on their wish list within the next 6 months, and they'll be invited to come on the show to acknowledge and share what it was. Now, even if they're out of town, we're going to pay for them to come in. The only caveat, Barry, is that we're going to expect them to pay it forward by sponsoring at least one kit. So somebody that's suffering from blood cancer may get saved, and they'll be able to prepare something or accomplish something on their wish list that right now they may not be able to. So we want everybody to accomplish something within the next 6 months, and then hopefully out of the kindness of their heart, pay it forward so other people have the same luxury and gift that they had.
You know, that's an interesting challenge, Gregg. It's an interesting challenge, and I kind of want to join in on it. I think I'm gonna do the 6 month challenge.
I'm gonna have you hold that for 2 minutes, because right now Leora Lieberman, our other co-host who's on special assignment, calling in right now, and we want to know where Leora is. Leora, you're with us.
Hi, I'm here. How are you?
Good. As I always say now, where in the world is Leora Lieberman?
I'm actually in New Orleans for an interview at Tulane University.
Go Green Wave.
I know. It's exciting stuff. I'm happy to be here, though.
Well, welcome.
So,
thanks, Leora. So, what are you interviewing for?
So, I'm actually interviewing, as I said before, on previous shows. I'm interviewing for medical school. So, I'm a little nervous for the interview, but I'm excited because it's all good things, and hopefully, it'll go well. So, I'm excited.
It's gonna go real well. I know that you have a couple of interviews set up over the next month, and all of your family at Gift of Life is really rooting for you. So, how's the master's program going?
The master's program is going really, really well. I didn't have class today, but I have class tomorrow, and I'm in some pretty cool classes. One is biostatistics, which completely goes over my head a little bit. I'm not used to statistics, but it's a great course. It's really interesting. And another one that's called U.S. Healthcare. It's all about the U.S. healthcare system and public policy, and there's all the things that are very relevant to us in the news and the new healthcare act and very relevant information, which is great. And then the other class is social behavioral science. So all the behaviors that, you know, dictate our everyday life in terms of health and why we do the things we do, like why we brush our teeth, why we don't brush our teeth. That's what that class is about. So it's really cool and very interesting because I love psychology and I love, you know, why we do things, and I love knowing why all those behaviors happen. So it's really, really great. I'm excited.
Let me ask you, L Squared, I don't know if you were on hold and you were able to hear, but we have a bucket list challenge or a wish list challenge to our listening audience. Do you have one that you may want to share with us?
I do actually. I've been thinking a lot lately about, you know, I think it's just because I'm applying to medical school and my future is so much on the horizon at this point. And I think I've been thinking a lot, you know, what will be fulfilling in life and what will be meaningful and how will I get those things to make me feel like I'm contributing positively to society. And I think this summer was an amazing fulfillment of my bucket list, just working with Sammy and working with you guys. And I really felt fulfilled, and I really felt like I was important and I had meaning. And I think just, you know, working with families and making a difference in people's lives, I think that's just an overarching theme of my bucket list. And if that's all I accomplished in life, I think it was worth it. So,
no, so I think that's... I had to give a special thank you. We've mentioned Sammy on every show, and we've all made it a mission at Gift of Life to find her a match. But Leora is the one that made the introduction through one of Leora's sorority sisters. So, you know, we're working hard, and, you know, we're going to get these kits tested, and hopefully one of them will be her perfect match. And as I said on Saturday, 5 years from now, I want her to be the MC of the fantastic event.
Me too. And I think that's what's so great about the show and so great about the cause and so great about working with Sammy is we see a positive future ahead, and we have the hope that's there. We have hope that she's going to be okay. And that's what gets people through is hope and happiness and positivity and looking towards the future and being happy towards, you know, accomplishing all of our bucket lists. And, you know, that's what gets everyone through. So I was very happy to do that this summer. Very, very happy.
Leora, as you very well may know, this month is Blood Cancer Awareness Month. And what is your message for all of our listeners out there as to what is Blood Cancer Awareness Month? Why is it Blood Cancer Awareness Month? And why is it important that we are aware of blood cancer?
Right. That's a great question. I think, you know, why is it important that we're aware of it? I think because it affects everyone of all different ages. You know, we work with people at Gift of Life who are 2 years old, but we also work with patients who are 67 years old, and it's something that can affect everyone and anyone. And I think, you know, just as a basic human value, we're all community and we all should care about each other. So when something affects me, it affects other people. And I think, you know, I would challenge everyone to think of someone who they don't know that was affected by cancer, don't have a family member, don't have a friend. You know, we're all affected by cancer in some way or another. So it's important that we care, and it's important that, you know, we raise awareness for causes, because awareness will hopefully transpire action. And, you know, we can't do anything alone in life. We need people to help. So it's important that we have months like this to really get people to know about our cause. And at Gift of Life, our cause is blood cancer, because bone marrow transplants are like the direct treatment for cancer. So for us, it's important that people know about this cause and know how to help. And it's important because I think sometimes people, especially my age, who might not have the financial resources to help, it's important to know that just, you know, spreading awareness, just telling a friend what blood cancer is, telling a friend, you know, how
you're
they
so
can
right,
help.
You're so right, Leora. That makes all the difference.
No, just the takeaway is the cancer does not discriminate. Let's get the word out. And last but not least, please listen if you're in the underrepresented communities.
Exactly. We
have the resources to mobilize, so let's make those contacts, let's spread the awareness, let's get lay leaders involved so we could eradicate this disease. If I could echo both of your sentiments, cancer does not discriminate, and we're all one big family. a match anywhere, anytime, for anyone. So let's mm-hmm. get to it so we don't have to see people suffering.
Leora, thanks so much for your call.
Oh, you're welcome. Have a great day, guys.
All right, you too. We'll see you next week, and best of luck on your interview.
All right.
Thank you so much. We have another call lined up.
Frank.
Frank?
Frank, you're on the air. Frank, go ahead.
Hey, this is Frank. How you guys doing?
Hey, Frank, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Suffolk County, Long Island.
Oh, where about in Suffolk? I'm from Long Island myself.
Bayshore.
Oh, Bayshore. I think that's out in the exit 60s. Frank, before we take your question, did you hear that we're having a walk this Sunday at Eisenhower Park?
I saw some advertisements for it out here in Bayshore. There's quite a bit of people from Suffolk County coming, so I know somebody from work who knows somebody, so the email kind of got passed around a little bit. So it should be Sunday at Eisenhower, right?
You got it. Look for me, Frank, when you get there. My name is Gregg Francis. So did you hear about our bucket list or wish list? I shouldn't say bucket list, but wish list.
I did.
So do you have one that you think that you could accomplish within 6 months?
So mine's kind of interesting. My son, Frank Jr., he's actually a Steelers fan. I'm a Jets fan. So it's difficult because they're playing each other on November 9th.
So, I know I'm gonna actually be in Washington D.C. And wait, are you the Jets fan or is your son?
Oh, well, I'm a Jets fan. He's a Steelers fan.
All right, I'm a Jets fan too, so I'm with you, Frank Senior.
So you know the suffering.
Yeah, no, I know the suffering, but we're 1-0. It wasn't the prettiest win, but we're 1-0.
Not bad. I'll take it.
So what's the wish list item within the next 6 months with you and Frank Jr.?
The wish list, it's kind of for him, but it's also for me. I just don't tell him that. For him, I told him if he gets straight A's up to his progress report, which is right before then, we'll go to the game. For me, it's kind of a wish list for me, though, because my father, he actually passed away of cancer when I was a young kid, so we didn't get to do stuff like this. So for me, it's kind of a wish list because I got to do something with my son that I never got to do, as a child myself. So it's part of me. It's a wish list, and I'm rooting for him that he gets it so that I can go too. I kind of thought about that when you guys were talking about this stuff.
You stole my thunder, and this was heavy. So, Frank Jr., if you're listening, if you're in school now, I want you to play this back on Ustream or YouTube. I want you to get this done for yourself, and I want you to get this done for Dad. And even though the Jets may win in a nail biter, you guys will have a great time. And Frank, how'd you hear about Gift of Life with Gregg?
I heard about it because I went on the website. We got a couple of guys out here from work who know this other organization, Prevail. I looked on their website. It brought me to this. So kind of a few different steps along down the line, I found Gift of Life.
All right. Well, we really appreciate your tenacity. Yeah. Find us out.
No. This is very exciting. And then with that being said, just spread the word to your friends and please spread the word. I know that you're going to the walk, but this is Blood Cancer Awareness Month. So, Frank, if you could spread the word, we'd really appreciate it.
And Frank, also, I want to add on to this. If you do end up, if your son on his progress report ends up making the cut and you guys get to go to that game, let us know. We would love to hear how that goes.
And I'll take it one step further, Frank. If you and your son make it, where's the game? Is it in the Meadowlands or is it in Pittsburgh?
No, that's in Jersey. It's Meadowlands.
If Frank Jr. gets it and we want to see his report card, what we'll do here at the Gift of Life with Gregg, we'll fly both of you in so you could tell us about your experience.
Okay.
All right.
I love that, going to Florida in November.
Yeah, it's not the worst place to be. Sometimes it's warm here in the summer, but November, it's pretty nice. So
there you go. Tell June to get straight A's and he gets a free trip to Orlando.
And well, yeah. No, Boca.
Boca.
All right, he knows where he's sick today, so Orlando, Boca. He got in the right state. All right, I appreciate the call, Frank.
All right, have a good one.
You got it.
You too. interesting calls we're getting today. I want to tell you about my 6 month wish list item, I guess I'll talk about for a little bit.
Go ahead, please.
6 month wish list. You know, Gregg, I wrote in college, and I wrote a lot in college. I did a lot of sculling. For those of you who don't know, it's when you row the boat with two oars in each hand, or one oar in each hand, two oars in total. And I didn't get to do as much of that as I would have liked. That being said, now I'm down here in Florida. I've got some more time on my hands, and hopefully I'm not having any physical ailments like today.
No, you're going to bounce back from that just fine.
Yeah, yeah, it's just a cold. But there's a rowing association in Fort Lauderdale, and I want to make it a mission for myself to join the master's program in the next 6 months if I can make it happen with time constraints and whatnot. And who knows, you might see Barry Kaplan rowing on the Fort Lauderdale Inlet.
And you would be a cheap date to come here because you're here anyway. So, yeah. But you're not eligible as one of three prizes. But I want to see you get that done. I really would like to see you get that done. So we'll move forward.
I think I could do it, you know. And, you know, there's a joke going around the office. I can't run 3 miles. We'll see about that, won't we, after my membership on the rowing association. Looks like we got another call coming in.
Yeah, no, this is an interesting. I think that you'll be able to make the rowing. Okay, we got a call from Sam. Sam, are you there?
Hello?
Sam, how are you?
Doing well. How are you?
Doing good. This is the Gift of Life with Gregg. Sam, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Denver today, the Mile High City.
Mile High, and your Broncos got off to a good start. They made it a little interesting at the end, but how's the Mile High City treating you?
Oh, I love it out here. I moved out here about 10 years ago with my wife. You know, we're an outdoorsy bunch originally from the East Coast, but, you know, we love it out here. I couldn't be happier and more thrilled to be in this city.
Oh, how did, I think this might be our first call from Denver, but how do you hear about the Gift of Life with Gregg?
Yeah, sure. Actually, you know, I have a nephew, and he, through Facebook, I guess, he saw a post about a campus ambassador program. And he told me about it, and I did a little research on the organization, saw there was a show today, and I called up.
All right. Yeah, we're going to get into the Campus Ambassador Program on the next show.
Actually, I'll give a preview in about 15, 20 minutes. I can give a quick preview of that. But go ahead, Sam. Go ahead, share with us why you called today.
Yeah, well, I wanted to call to talk about my bucket list item.
And what is your bucket list item?
Well, me and my wife, you know, for many years now, we've been talking about going back to the East Coast and hiking the whole Appalachian Trail. I've read, you know, books about it, and, you know, as I mentioned, we're real outdoorsy people, and, you know, I figure, you know, I haven't seen the majority of the south of the East Coast, and, you know, I'd love to get out there with her, but we're finding it real difficult, you know, to take the time off. And also, you know, the funds to get to the East Coast, it's expensive. So those are the two limiting factors. So, you know, hopefully within the next couple of years, we'll be able to make it happen.
You know, Sam, I've flown into Denver before. Beautiful airport, but man, is it expensive because the plane's got to go up all, you know, it's not only a question of length, it's also a question of height. They got to climb those mountains to get in the, you know, in and out. So I definitely sympathize with your problem there.
Sam, yeah. I sympathize with the economics. I sympathize with the time, but somebody that's, you know, recalibrated his life when he lost a parent, please find the time to do the things with your loved one that you want to do, because your job's going to always be there, and money, as I like to say, at times in our life is fungible. So go ahead and really see if you could do that with your wife, because it's a memory that both of you will keep, you know, for your lifetimes together.
Yeah, you know, I appreciate that, and you know, we really hope to get it done one day. And, you know, just hearing the fact that you've been able to, you know, make some changes is incredible, you know, inspiring to me. And, you know, well, I'm definitely going to talk with my wife again over dinner tonight about how we're going to make it happen.
And Sam, you know, the Appalachian Trail, I hear, is absolutely beautiful, so you couldn't have chosen a better wish list item.
Yeah, certainly. You know, I've read books, seen movies, and, you know, I've climbed one of the peaks. Is actually in Maine, well, the end of the trail. It's called Mount Katahdin in northern Maine. And I've hiked that, so I've done a little piece of it, but I certainly got a couple months that I need to dedicate to get the whole thing done.
All righty. So, Sam, I want you and your wife to make that happen. As I mentioned to all the callers today, this is Blood Cancer Awareness Month. Please try to spread the word, get more people tested. If they're ineligible to test, they could contribute financially. Let's eradicate this disease, and we could all do it together. Thanks so much for your phone call, and enjoy the Mile High City.
Hey, thank you, Gregg. Thank you, Barry.
All right. Thanks again, Sam, for your call. We're going to take another quick commercial break. When we get back, Gregg, you're going to share with us another challenge you have for the audience, something, let's say, call it up the ante.
We're going to up the ante, and yeah, it's a show about challenges.
All right. When we get back, stay with us.
Are you in the market for a health plan? If so, please visit my good friend Gary at Health Plans Unlimited. No plan is too big or too small. Gary will customize a plan that's affordable and comprehensive, just for you. If you're interested, please visit Gary Goldman, the best in the biz, at www.healthplansunlimited.com. Again, that's www.healthplansunlimited.com. Or you can call Gary Goldman directly on his personal line at 954-303-6676. Again, that's 954-303-6676. And tell him that Gregg sent you directly from the Gift of Life. Health Plans Unlimited. We have the health plan for you. ThrowItBetter.com. Do you need help with your bowling game? Are you taking the right five-step approach? If you want to become a competitive bowler, even a recreational bowler that's considering joining a league, or a league bowler that's considering joining a tournament, you need to see Vince. He's going to show you how to throw it better. He'll get you the right equipment, he'll show you the right approach, and as a certified coach himself, he'll put you in the best position to succeed. If you're interested, please visit Vince at throwitbetter.com and tell him that Gregg sent you. Again, that's www.throwitbetter.com. If you own a business and have the need for commercial insurance, I suggest you call Chris Moore of Brown & Brown Insurance in Fort Lauderdale. Chris has been in the commercial insurance business for over 30 years and can handle any company's need for property, general liability, workers' compensation, and automobile, just to name a few. Brown & Brown, being countrywide and the fifth largest agency in the country, gives Chris the tools he needs to meet all your insurance needs. So call Chris at 954-331-1420. Again, that's 954-331-1420. We want to extend a special thanks to our friends at the Boca West Foundation for all the wonderful work they do for Gift of Life and for all the meaningful service they give to the Boca Raton community. For over 3 years, the Boca West Foundation has generously supported local charities in the Boca Raton area. The Boca West Foundation, it's all about the kids. Welcome back to The Gift of Life with Gregg, the show that talks about giving and receiving. I'm your co-host, Leora Lieberman, and I'm here with my host, Gregg Francis, and co-host, Barry Kaplan. If you'd like to call into our show, we'd love to hear from you. Please call 888-565-1470. Again, that's 888-565-1470. And now, back to our show.
And we're back with The Gift of Life with Gregg. Barry Kaplan here, and we didn't tell you guys that the word of the week this week is values. Again, the weekly word of wisdom, values. And Gregg, why don't you tell us why that is?
I will in a moment. I believe that we have another call coming in, but we wanted to make it a little bit easier. I know, Barry, the first couple of words that you've been coming up with brought me back to my SAT days. But right now, I believe that we have Alice on the line. Alice, can you hear us?
I can, Gregg. How are you?
Doing well. And Alice, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Boston, Massachusetts.
Boston, MA. Well, it's nice to have you on the show. How'd you hear about us?
Thank you. I have actually done some volunteer work for Gift of Life, and in fact, my son was a donor.
Wow. Wow. So, it's great. It's great to hear your, it's great to hear your voice, and let me say thank you on behalf of your family.
Thank you. Thank you. I wanted to let you know, Gregg, that the Gift of Life has been life-altering for our entire family.
And I can't thank you enough. I know that we plan on having a walk in the Boston area next year. So when it gets closer to that time, we will certainly post it on the show and on the website at www.giftoflife.org. So, Alice, I don't know if you heard, but we had the challenge today about a wish list or a bucket list.
Yes.
And do you have one yourself?
Oh, boy. I have a lot of things on my bucket list, although I have been so fortunate that I have checked off a lot of things on my bucket list.
Then a lucky lady you are.
Excuse me?
I said a lucky lady you are. That's fantastic. I love when people say that.
Thank you. Thank you. And I'd say one of the things on my bucket list, and this doesn't sound huge, but would be to go zip lining in Costa Rica.
Zip lining
in Costa Rica. So, Alice, how are we going to make this happen?
Excuse me?
How are we going to make this happen?
Well, again, fortunately, it shouldn't be too hard. So when the time comes that we can plan a vacation and get ourselves down to Costa Rica, we just need to sign up for a trip.
Please, please make that happen. I love when people, Barry and I, and I know that you said your son was a donor?
Yes, my son was a donor.
And he's a hero in my eyes. So you know how this disease affects not only the patients, but their families as well. So
I certainly do, Gregg. And, through my son's donation, again, we have become, my entire family, volunteers for the Gift of Life. And, it is incredible. I'm not sure who really gets the greater gift, the donor or the donee. I haven't figured that out.
You know what? An interesting blog that I read, people said it's the most selfish and selfless thing that they've ever done. Selfless because obviously they saved a person's life. Selfish because they never felt so good doing something in their life. So I think both of them are very, it's a very valid point.
Yeah. Another thing that was on my bucket list, but it's not going to happen, and I was quite disappointed when I swabbed, I wanted more than anything to be able to get that phone call that my son got telling me that I was a donor. And unfortunately, I have a medical condition where I take a medication so that I got the call, but I couldn't be on the list. So that one won't be able to happen. But, we've been talking to just about everyone we know, trying to get them to become part of the registry.
You want to know something, Alice? A generation removed, and hopefully it felt vicarious to you, but your families in and of themselves are true heroes. As I've been saying to all of our callers today, it's Blood Cancer Awareness Month, and I know it's in your literal DNA to spread the word. So if you could continue doing that, we really thank that you support the Gift of Life, and on behalf of Barry and myself, I cannot thank you enough.
Absolutely, and we will be there at the walk in Boston next year. We look forward to hosting a walk in Boston, and in fact, my family will try to get down to Boca this winter to join you as well.
All right, please, please keep in touch. Our office is 1-800-9-MARROW. And please give me a call so we could speak further. And when you come down to Boca, we could certainly connect.
Terrific. Thank you very much, Gregg. And continue to do the great work that you're doing.
Thank you so, so much.
Alice, thank you so much.
Thank you, Barry. So long.
We have another call up in line. Willie. Willie, you're on the air.
Willie, could you hear us?
Hey. Yeah, this is Willie.
Willie, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Michigan.
Michigan, well, the Midwest. Yeah, that constitutes the Midwest. Where? How'd you hear about us, Willie?
I have a college friend. I'm in school down in Indiana, but my college friend ran some drives with his fraternity, so we're trying to get involved too.
All right. What school in Indiana or?
Oh, in Indiana, Bloomington.
Oh, okay, IU.
You got it. Yes, sir.
All right, we're getting calls all over the map today. Have you heard about the challenge that we have, Willie?
I was just listening to the bucket list challenge.
Yes.
So mine's a little interesting. So I was really lucky. I got to travel around a lot as a kid. So for mine, it's kind of strange, but I just want to be able to actually move back home and raise a family back home. And it's kind of silly, but that's kind of all I ever wanted. You know, kind of got to travel around a little bit. But to be able to move back home and just have a healthy family, I heard someone else speak before about they lost a parent, and I lost a parent pretty young. So for me, that was really all I wanted.
Yeah, I think that we had another person, Frank, in Frank Sr. in New York that lost his parent at a young age. So where is home for you?
I'm from Bloomfield, right outside of Detroit.
Oh, all right. So you're in the, you're not that far. And what year are you in school?
I'm a senior.
All right.
All right. So what's your major?
I am a philosophy major.
Okay.
All righty. So you want to know something? After graduation, please keep in touch. But during your senior year, if you'd like to run a drive, it is Blood Cancer Awareness Month, please call up 1-800-9-MARROW and speak to Bridget, and we'll get IU back on the drive map.
Sounds good to me. I'd like to do that.
Excellent, Willie.
That would be fantastic. I know that we have other calls today, but I want to put out a public service announcement. And I don't know if it's public service, but it's something that Frank Sr. brought up today. I was having a soda yesterday before I bowled, and I overheard, you know, what seemed like a very nice gentleman, and he had a booming voice. It sounded like a great radio voice.
A sonorous voice.
A sonorous voice. I love that word. And he was saying that his job consumes his life, and he only sees his kids about 5 minutes a day. So here's my challenge to parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins. I know that times are tough. As we mentioned before, some caller said that the economy is hitting them hard. But my public service announcement to you is to make it a priority to spend a night with your child, children, loved ones, whether it's having dinner, you know, reading to them, watching band practice, coaching your child's team, playing games. It's a memory that I promise you will last you all a lifetime. Why this was touching to me yesterday is I lost my dad, who I was very close to, when my father was 59 years old. He almost made 60. And I think about him every day. And some of my fondest memories from my childhood was my dad coaching my travel soccer team. Now, next Monday, I'm going to be 45 years old, so you know, you recalibrate, you reflect. And I'm so appreciative that he made it home every week, at least once a week, from his job in New Jersey to Long Island, New York. I think it was 60-some-odd miles each way, but by 5:30. And every weekend, he coached my team. And towards the end of his life, he told me that one of the most fun parts of his life was, you know, was coaching me and coaching the soccer team. And it's something now that I'm doing with both of my sons. So parents, grandparents, whether, again, it's coaching, reading, watching TV, having dinner together, playing games, please, please, please make the time at least once a week to share time with your family. If you think about it in retrospect, the things that we deem, you know, overly critical, most of the time it could wait until the next day. So if I could get one thing across, it's that please spend time with your loved ones. Please make it a priority once a week to share a meal, to do something together. Whether it's just simple watching a TV show, make it your time with your family.
And, you know, Gregg, I'm a recent college graduate. I want to piggyback off of that challenge that you just issued. You know, it's easy for a college-age kid like myself to kind of get off the grid and not keep in contact with their family as much as they should. So I want to go out and go on a limb and say on the reverse. Kids, go out, spend some more time with your family, spend some more time with your parents. They're much cooler than you think they are.
No, it was just... The guy was just so utterly consumed by his job that I don't want him to be 20 years from now and he's like, you know, I wish I could have spent more time. But Ken on the other side of the glass is telling us that it's almost time to go. Listen, I want everybody to have a great week. It's Blood Cancer Awareness Month. Go Jets, let's beat the Packers. And everybody, God bless, let's have a great week.
Thanks for tuning in to The Gift of Life with Gregg. I wanted to personally say thank you to everyone who participated in today's show. And I also wanted to let you know if that you're interested in what we do here at The Gift of Life, please call 1-800-9-MARROW. That's 1-800-9-MARROW. Or you can visit our website at www.giftoflife.org. Again, that's www.giftoflife.org. Even though we're wrapping up our show today, remember, you must always unwrap the gift of life.